Hello, my name is Lindsay Moynihan, and I am an art teacher. The following movie is all about the journey I've been on throughout my first 2 years of teaching in the public schools. I hope you enjoy. Buongiorno! One of the things I like to do to make my class a little more fun and, shall we say, adventurous, is to choose different countries to focus on. At the beginning of this school year, our focus was on Italy. Students were able to listen to Italian music, taste Italian food, learn to speak a little Italian, and of course become familiar with Italian art. La Befana, the Italian Christmas witch, made for a fun and interesting project. My 6th grade students learned sewing techniques, fabric mache, and discovered the legend of Old Befana. Students were thrilled to have their work on display in our school's library. It gave them a chance to show off their creations to all of their friends. During the Italian unit, students were able to get an idea of what painter Michelangelo must have gone through while painting the Sistine Chapel. While laying on their backs creating their own celestial masterpieces, students discovered how difficult it must have been to paint this way for 7 years. Students gained a new appreciation for Michelangelo and had fun at the same time. Eighth grade students learned to create their own Venetian carnival masks. Molded from plaster to fit each student's face, these masks became a form of self-expression as well as a history lesson. Next on our journey around the world came a familiar place, the United States. During this unit, students created textural paintings of delectable desserts inspired by artist Wayne Thiebaud. While painting on stretched canvas and easels, students gained a sense of what it is like to be a real artist. These paintings turned out to be a class favorite, which may have had something to do with the ice cream sundae party we had at the end of the lesson. After figuring out the complex strip paintings of Jackson Pollock and trying their hand at slopping the paint around themselves, students realized that art can be both a fun adventure and a very serious business all at the same time. Last year, one of the countries we looked at was Mexico. With its bright colors and playful music, Mexico proved to be an enjoyable country to visit. I incorporate language into my daily lessons as much as possible. From Frida Kahlo and Jose Posada to Pablo Picasso, who is actually from Spain, students discovered the beauty and rich culture of this amazing country. Although this was the first high school art class I've had since my internship, I rediscovered my passion for teaching art on a more advanced level. The students in this class were all introductory students. Nonetheless, there was some amazing talent discovered. Throughout the trimester, we looked at pop art, sculpture, drawing, and painting. One of the favorite projects were the visual puns. We have a rocking chair, popsicle, a Dr. Pepper, and a bullfighter. Students were able to express their creativity and individuality through the use of techniques learned in class. Some discovered dream worlds and imaginary creatures. Questions pointing me in a crooked line. while others became familiarized with sunken ships and mysterious things that lie beneath the ocean blue.
Shook it up.
Towards the end of my first year teaching, I felt it was important to showcase all of the hard work my students and I had put in. Creating the middle school art show was a daunting task, but proved to be more rewarding than I could have imagined. For many talented art students, this was an opportunity to really show off. Some of these kids don't participate in sports and may not have the best grades, and so for them to be proud of their accomplishments in art and want to share that with others is all the reward I need. Another program I assisted in creating was the Multicultural Festival held at the Saugatuck Center for the Arts. I created a project for over 600 students based on the Mexican game of La Lotería. Students created a class mosaic of a giant Lotería card, which was displayed in a gallery right next to the visiting artist's painted version of the game. This year marked the induction of the very first Saugatuck Middle School National Junior Art Honor Society. Students involved with this group volunteer throughout the community at different art events. In addition, we met once a week for 6 weeks to participate in an open studio workshop. Here, students were able to create whatever kind of art they wanted. Throughout the last 2 years, I have had several students receive honors and awards at various art competitions, including one Silver Key and one Honorable Mention at the Scholastic Art and Writing Awards, 8 pieces of student work displayed at the regional show, and 3 pieces at the state show. The imovie Gallery in downtown Saugatuck held a fundraising event for the Solar Circle Group. This group raises money to send solar ovens to schools and communities in rural Africa. This year, we were asked to create artwork to go on display at the gallery. We decided to make African Tinga Tinga paintings inspired by art from Tanzania. Although the work was never meant for purchase, several patrons of the gallery began bidding on the pieces at the fundraiser. 3 of my Art 1B students decided to donate their paintings to the Solar Circle Group to help raise money for the cause. I can't begin to explain how proud I am of these 3 girls. Overall, it was a great experience for everyone involved. Although I am a dedicated and passionate art teacher, I'm also very passionate about my own work. Throughout the years, I have had several paintings of mine displayed in boutiques and galleries. The pieces in this section are currently on display at St. Mary's Hospital in Grand Rapids. I pour my heart and soul into my teaching during the school year and enjoy doing the same with my painting during the summer. Cause the afternoon's already coming on. And I said, who?
See, we made it through another day. Then I said,